Grace parked and got out. The area was peaceful, birdsong filling the air. Sherry's house stood on a corner lot, a white two-story frame model built in the hope that arose after the Second World War. Its paint had blistered in places. A few shingles had escaped from the roof. The front porch appeared sunken, and slats were missing from the white wooden fence that hemmed in neglected shrubs. Parked well into the driveway and nearly concealed by overgrowth was Sherry's Traverse. All of its doors, including the rear hatch, were open. Sherry? No answer. No one was there. Grace walked down the driveway, past the SUV to the back door of the house. She knocked. No answer. She knocked again, harder, and the door creaked open. 92. San Diego, California. Sherry Louise Penmark.
That's the name of the person who'd rented the red Hyundai Santa Fe from us,
Phil Mattson told Elson and McDowell from United Liberty Coast's office in Dallas. Investigators moved fast, running Penmark's name through local and national databases.
Here's Penmark's San Diego address,
Elson said.
It matches the address on her California driver's license and the registration of a white Chevrolet Traverse.
The Hyundai was rented to us on the date noted there, with no issues and has since been rented out. We can locate it,
Mattson said.
Phil, we'll get more warrants, but we'll need to seize that vehicle and put it on a flatbed for processing,
Elson said.
We'll work with you on that,
Mattson said. The Las Vegas detectives turned to Emery Moore, who joined them along with several senior San Diego commanders to determine how to move on Sherry Penmark's address.
We've checked Penmark's name,
Captain Kathleen Brockway said.
So far, she's got a clean sheet. No arrests, no warrants.
Elsa nodded.
Now that you've got this new information, we can go a couple of ways,
Brockway said.
Option one. Penmark, being a family friend, could be harboring a runaway. She's misguided in her efforts, but no harm done. We could send a car over, knock on her door for a conversation.
Elson and McDowell didn't say anything, waiting for the captain to offer another option.
Option two, if you believe Penmark kidnapped Riley Jarrett and is holding her, then we set up on her house. Wait for her to come out and get rolling. That gets her safely away from the house. We grab her, then check the house for the girl. End of story.
Option two,
Elson said, past giving anyone the benefit of the doubt.
Done,
Brockway said.
We'll get things moving.
93. San Diego, California.